taking a stand against the myriad of problems facing South Africa. Poverty, crime, corruption, farm murders and gender-based violence are among the many issues the group is raising. The protest comes in the back of alleged corruption linked to COVID-19 procurement. It also follows the latest murder of yet another young woman, Juanita Willemser from Horsten in the Overberg, allegedly by someone well known to the family. Organisers say South Africans are being failed at all levels, socially, economically and politically.
We say no to corruption, we say yes to direct elections, we want accountability, we want our country to be in the hands of the people that will best look after the country. At the moment it's not in the hands of those people. We have 15 million people that are starving in South Africa. It's unacceptable. We have the worst crime we've ever had in our history. It's absolutely unacceptable.
The movement is supported by individuals and various civil society organizations.
I'm here to say that enough to the killing of our children, to the hurt and the pain of our children.
The reason why I came is specifically for gender-based violence. I've grown up seeing it and I know what it does to families, I know what it does to kids.
We can't wait on the government anymore to change this country. There are too many people that are suffering in poverty, broken promises, corruption.
The movement says it will mobilize in every community so that voters are empowered to choose leaders and hold them accountable. The protest kickstarts its campaign for a system of direct elections before the national poll in 2020. Vanessa Puna, SABC News, Cape Town.